Good morning, Flyers, and welcome back to the Early Bird. I'm your host, Griffin Yarmaloff. Alongside me, as always, is the man, Mr. Shea Curry.
You know me, I'm back. Morning.
Happy New Year, FHS. We have an amazing episode to get you back into school, so we're going to keep it light, chill, and easy morning. So we got a Monday movie rant to kick off 2022. It's going to be a great year and a great episode, so let's roll the intro. Welcome back to School Flyers, and hope you all had a Merry Christmas. The first movie I want to talk about is Nightmare Alley. Director Guillermo del Toro wins and has won many awards when he releases movies. His latest, The Shape of Water, has won him Best Picture and Best Directing at the Oscars and around the world at film festivals. Guillermo del Toro is the master of horror and brings sci-fi concepts to the big screen. One of my favorite pieces of work he's produced is Pan's Labyrinth because of its breathtaking images and mystical concepts. Nightmare Alley was his first non-sci-fi project, and although still captivating, did not match the level of work he's produced in the past. I have no real complaint for this movie necessarily, but I felt it lacked a sense of stake. Everything Bradley Cooper did in this movie had no emphasis, and the storytelling had just a boring conclusion with unrelatable characters. Honestly, like, this was a good introduction to, like, regular filmmaking for Guillermo del Toro. But, like, in conclusion, so-and-so. Next up is Kingsman. I love the Kingsman movies. The first two were absolutely great, and the third one was just terrible. I mean, this one was not that good. It excelled in absolutely zero categories, and in a word, it was mid. Licorice Pizza was a fantastic movie. This movie was gas. I love Paul Thomas Anderson, and this movie matched some of his best work. The storytelling of PTA is incredible, as each one of his movies, like The Master, There Will Be Blood, Phantom Thread, Mangolia, all contain. Each movie starts with two characters talking and ends with the same two characters talking, like 2.5 hours, 3 hours later. It's awesome because Licorice Pizza followed the exact same concept, where a guy met a girl, they fell in love at the end, and it's done. That's simple. But the complex character development just pulls you into the lives of the two protagonists, and it feels so real. This movie gets my stamp of approval, 10 out of 10, must recommend. The Matrix series. So I saw there was a new Matrix movie that came out, so I was like, dope, I've never seen any of these before. So I watched all the Matrix movies to, like, prepare myself, and then I watched the new Matrix movie. They were all right. The first one was better than the second and the third, but Matrix 4 Resurrection was absolutely okay. It was almost exactly what The Matrix was already, which is nice because it's like a breath of fresh air of the continuity, of them sticking to their roots. But it was still like whatever. If you like The Matrix movies, know that like the apple doesn't fall far from the tree for this one. But like Matrix Resurrections, it's like the second best Matrix movie in my opinion. Lamb. This next movie is called Lamb. It's a horror film from the Netherlands. I'm not allowed to go more in depth about what this movie is about, but if you're crazy and you like crazy things, watch it. Don't do any research before, just go ahead, click it. It's a fun time. Don't Look Up. Don't Look Up was a fantastic satirical movie about like just our current political climate in the country. It stars Leonardo DiCaprio, Jennifer Lawrence, Kid Cudi, you know, everyone. It was this tragedy-based comedy, it was satirical and sad, and I'm running out of time, so I gotta speed this up. The Tragedy of Macbeth, oh my god, masterpiece. Denzel Washington, Frances McDormand. Okay, I'm still short on time here. Last movie, Pig. This one starred Nicolas Cage. Nicolas Cage was a chef, and he had a pig. 10 out of 10, you should watch it. If you like Nicolas Cage, or if you like any movies at all, this is perfect for you. Alright, and those are all the movies I watched over December break, and now live in the studio with The Pledge is Jow.
This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me.
We stand for The Pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Jal. Since it's the new year, we don't have many announcements for today, so we're going to kick it off with the one, the only, Miss Banach.
Good morning. morning, everyone. It is so great to see you. We missed you so much. I hope you had a wonderful holiday break. We're back. It goes by quickly, but I think that, you know, as we enter the next few weeks, we're going to be winding down semester one. We'll have mid-year exams coming up, beginning the 18th. I'm going to send that schedule out to everyone so that you have that. The number one thing that I'm going to bring up today, and you've heard me say it over and over, but there's only one way to wear your mask properly, and it's up over your nose at all times. So my expectation is that you're vigilant with that, and that please, when your teachers remind you, make sure your mask is on properly. Again, we, as you know, there's an uptick, and so we all need to do our part. So please, please be mindful of that. We're going to be sending out some messaging about mask wearing and expectations to the community as well. But again, welcome back, everyone. I hope you had a great break, and I hope you have a great day. All right, that's it for me. Back to Griffin and Shay.
That's all for today's episode of The Early Bird. If you enjoyed this episode and you want to watch it again, you can find it on our YouTube or in our Instagram bio at Framingham High Studios. Shay, it's 2022. What's your New Year's resolution?
Man, I don't know. Just live life to fullest, I guess, you know?
Live
just
life
enjoy the rest of our senior year.
You only live once.
Have some fun, YOLO.
Routine mindset.
Yeah, exactly. Right. What about you?
I think I want to make The Early Bird the greatest talk show on the planet. Okay. I mean, like, we're already, like, number two, like, right behind, like, Kimmel. But, yeah, like, we're going to get there eventually in, like, the ratings.
Okay.
But, like, that's our resolutions. We want to hear from you. Tell us about your resolutions at Framingham High Studios Instagram. And that's all for today's episode of The Early Bird. And remember, The Early Bird gets the worm.